the only surah in the whole Quran and started with what? Suratun anzalnaha wa faradna. This surah is very important. Anzalnaha wa faradna. Anania, Allah want to tell us, if you take the whole Quran not serious, Surah An-Nur, you have to take it serious. Because Surah An-Nur ni, selamat dalam rumah tangga, selamat keluar rumah tangga, di segi akhlak. That's why Imam Ghazali dalam buku Ihya Ulumuddin, and Umar ibn al-Khattab, zaman Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu, he said what? You must, at 9 years old, teach your children Surah An-Nur. From 9 years old, the children should know Surah An-Nur. Because Surah An-Nur can help a lot if the people understand. And min hayati, dosa zina tidak akan berlaku. And dosa zina ni, satu daripada dosa yang balik-balik Tuhan benci. Sampai Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, akan dapat empat keselakaan di dunia, empat keselakaan di akhirat nanti. Keselakaan di dunia, mati umur pendek, mati dalam suul khatimah. Harga pribadi pun jatuh dalam masyarakat. And in the same time, mesti mati dalam kemiskinan. That's why hadis Rasulullah SAW, وَبَشِّرِ الزَّانِي بِالْفَقْرِ وَلَوْ بَعْدَ حِينَ. Bagi beritalah ke orang yang zina ni, mesti akan jadi miskin, walaupun kemudian. Kalau tak taubat lah. Kalau taubat, insyaAllah lah. That's why the surah, فَإِنْ تَابُوا وَأَصْلَحُوا. Every now and then Allah berulang-ulang, فَإِنْ تَابُوا, فَإِنْ تَابُوا. Maknanya pintu taubat buka. Tapi kalau zina, and duduk insisting on zina, sampai mati, these four things will happen. Harga pribadi jatuh, mati dalam kemiskinan, mati dalam su'ul khatimah, and mati umur pendek. All this keselakaan dunia. Keselakaan akhirat, of course, number satu, siksa kubur. Number dua, siksa di mahsyar. Number tiga, malu depan orang ramai di mahsyar. Everyone will know. Akhir sekali, of course, number empat, seksa di neraka. Dan kerana itu, one surah khas. From A to Z, the surah is about zina. Zina, something that you have to avoid. Dalam rumah tangga pun ada adab. Keluar rumah tangga pun ada adab. We already no, sebab nuzul the surah was people buat tuduhan buruk terhadap Sayyidah Aisyah radhiyallahu anha, isteri baginda Rasulullah SAW. They accuse her of zina just because a man who is not muhrim, Safwan, his name Safwan bin Mi'tal, give her a lift on his unta. Unta, and of course, in front of everybody is open. But yet, because it was early in the morning, because she was left alone in the Badan Basir, her Salah, the man, the one who drive her unta, take the unta and left. He thought that she's inside the house, yang atas unta itu, and when people see her behind Safwan in the unta, the munafiqeen said what? Wallahi ma salima minha wa ma salimat minhu. Demi Allah, dia tak selamat lah sama Safwan. Dia zina dengan Safwan. Dia bermalam dengan Safwan. And of course, Sayyidah Aisyah, Allah membersihkan nama dia dan membersihkan nama Safwan melalui Al-Quran. That means what? It is not encouraged in Islam, a man and a woman become alone. Masti ada number three. Because Rasulullah said, مَجْتَمَعَ رَجُلٌ وَامْرَأَةٌ illa wa kana ash-shaytanu thalithuma. Tiap-tiap tempat ada man and woman alone, syaitan is number three. So in Islam, free mixing is not encouraged, unless of course ramai-ramai. And then Allah said, come lah, let me tell you, hey manusia, what are the steps that you should take to avoid zina. Number one, لا تدخلوا بيوتا غير بيوتكم حتى تستأنسوا وتسلموا على أهلها. Jangan masuk rumah orang tanpa izin dan tanpa yakin ada ramai. Don't masuk rumah orang and you are one to one only. Masih ada ramai, masih make sure ada ramai. Even Allah said in Surah An-Nur also, وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَكُمْ ارْجِعُوا فَارْجِعُوا. Salah mari, masuk. And kita masuk rumah Datuk misalnya, Datuk alone, doktor, please go back, I cannot attend you, it's not around, I must go back. I cannot say, biarlah Datuk, saya nak tunggu, saya mari jauh, I have to wait, cannot. Islam doesn't encourage one to one. If to one room I say go back, go back. وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَكُمْ ارْجِعُوا فَارْجِعُوا هُوَ أَزْكَى لَكُمْ. All this in Surah An-Nur. Kalau to one room I say go back, don't stay on. Because this might lead to fitna. So kurang-kurangnya, if I'm alone with that, someone can phone, say, Dr. Khalwat with your husband, you don't believe, go and see. Fitna besar, for no reason. So seeluk-eluknya, you avoid to be one to one. Okay. Number three, قُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ يَغُدُّوا مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِمْ. Wahai orang lelaki, control your eyes. Your eyes, you see for once, habis. Jangan duduk tengok Allah besarnya, Allah gemuknya, Allah hebatnya, Allah seksinya. Cannot. Control your eyes. وَيَحْفَظُوا فُرُوجَهُمْ. Jaga kehormatan diri. Don't buat benda-benda yang make you excited. Don't misuse. You must jaga. Okay. The same thing to the woman. قُلْ لِلْمُؤْمِنَاتِ يَقْضُضْنَ مِنْ أَبْصَارِهِمْ. Wahai orang perempuan, jaga mata. Don't misuse your eyes. Jangan mata jadi mata yang inviting. Because if we see, the surah started with what? Az-zaniyatu waz-zani. Started with woman. Maknanya, the one who start the zina is a woman, not the man. You must control your eyes. Don't keep on looking. Don't talk to make the man, you know, have some feelings towards you. Don't joke. Don't talk loudly. Don't say dirty jokes. All this in the Surah An-Nur. وَلَا يُظْهِرْنَ زِينَتَهُنَّ إِلَّا لِبُعُولَتِينَ. Berhias your berhiasan, your sexy, sexy parts, no one can see except your husband. Pakaian kita, aurat kita, the way we talk, the way we joke, the way we move, you must control, otherwise zina will happen. Okay. And of course, another thing to avoid zina, Allah said is what? Kalau orang lelaki nak kahwin, baik kahwin. Don't you feel you want to marry and you keep on tak kahwin, you will do the maksiat. And wahai orang perempuan, kalau lelaki, walaupun fakir, tapi dia good Muslim, akhlak baik, go ahead and marry him. Don't be so choosy. And if there is no jodoh juga, don't be frustrated that hari ini sama orang ni, esok sama lelaki ni, lusa. You better control yourself. And of course, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, kalau tak ada jodoh, ubat yang terbaik untuk control yourself is what? Puasa, riada, keep yourself busy in something, to lawan your nafsu. All this in Surah An-Nur. Because some ladies, bila tak ada jodoh, become frustrated, took a boyfriend, go out with boyfriend, balik malam lambat-lambat, all this can lead to zina. Kalau tak lead to zina pun, lead to fitnah, lead to rusak nama. So all this in Surah An-Nur. Jaga kehormatan diri, jaga marwah diri. Hukum is hukum. And then Allah today telling us, all this if you know, you have already got the Nur. If you know all this, you get the Nur. And your house will be full of Nur, full of Iman and Taqwa. Because the one who gives the Nur is Yabba, Allah. Allah gives the Nur melalui apa? Al-Quran dan ilmu. Orang yang jahil tidak serupa orang yang berilmu. So Allah said, walaupun Allahu nurus samawati wal ard. Aku ni Allah. Ini nur di langit, di bumi is from Allah. That's why di mahsyar muslimin dan muslimat yang saya hormat sekalian, langit sudah tak ada. Matahari pun sudah tak ada. Bulan pun sudah tak ada. Bintang-bintang pun sudah tak ada. Tapi still syarah. Syarah dengan apa? Nur Allah. Nur Allah. So Allah said, I am the Nur. Allahu nurus samawati wal ard. Aku ni Nur lani, Nur bumi. Ini Nur in this world, it comes from Allah. And some people, the search for Nur Allah is what? What is Nur Allah? Ilmu lah. Some people jahil, they don't get the Nur of Allah. They open their heart, gelak, gelemak. Their houses born gelak, gelemak. Full of masya, full of unhappiness. Padahal maybe they are very rich. They are very, have a lot of money, but the hati is very dark, and even they live not happy because they don't have Nur Allah. Allah give His Nur to people who really search for that Nur. What is that Nur? Is the Quran, the ilmu. If you have that Nur, you will be as if you have a blitter. Duduk dalam botol, inside your heart, niala all the time. That's why Nabi Yusuf alayhi salam, because he have the Nur, Siti Zulaika is very beautiful. And she ajak dia zina. And Allah said what? Hamma biha wa hamma bihi. Lekak dah zina nak jadi. Tapi oleh kerana dia ada the Nur of Allah, he did not do it. He didn't follow the shaitan. He didn't follow the nafsu. Because he have Nur Allah. You see, so if you have the Nur of Allah, by really practicing the Quran, practicing what we learn here, I really control my eyes. I really behave properly in front of the man. I'm not that loose. I don't just give the man, you know, a talk as if I am want him or what, or joke. I really follow the Nur. Inshallah, this Nur will protect you, will make you know how to behave, will make you have a limit in your life, not loose. So Allah said, Allahu Nuru Samawati wal Ard. And once you get this Nur, مثل نوره كمشكاة فيها مصباح. You know, tembak yang kita gantung chandelier ni. Itu مشكاة. Something inside your heart, like a مشكاة, the one we hang you see the chandelier? Sangkut the chandelier. Then the chandelier ni, inside your heart, is not even by itself, is like dalam satu botol lagi. Fi zujaja. He just give an example. That means what? You go anywhere, you are like diamond. Because the Nur ada all the time. You can protect yourself anywhere you go. If the man have this Nur, 10 girls also to do play in his hand, play in his leg, he will never do anything because he have the nur. If the woman born also have that nur, any man try to, she will never give herself because she have the nur. The nur to do niyala all the time. نور على نور نور الله لقي نور القرآن لقي inside your heart as if is a plate يعني يلا all the time you don't have to use matches you don't have to use minya is a very special plate يعني يلا all the time so Allah just giving an example of what of a mishka hang from that mishka blitta this blitta to do the lamb bottle and the lamb bottle ni ada a very special blitta yaniala with a minya very special minya as if minya come from minya zaitun yan very very special one yan boleh niala all the time it's just a chonto. That is why ilmu is very important. Kalau kita jahil, if you don't know, if you don't have these doses of akhlaq, you can lose your dignity anytime. Because jahilun, wal-iyazu billah. But if you have the nur, Allah said, it will protect you. You will be like a diamond. Anywhere you go, you will never lose your dignity because you have the nur. You know how to behave. You know when to say no. Ah, mashallah. Beautiful. Allahu nuru samawati wal ard. And then he gives the example. Mathalu nurihi kamishkatin fiha misbah. Al misbah fi zujaja. Bilit tatoo dudu dalam bottle. Ma'na niyaba. Never off. Niyala all the time. Subhanallah. Protected. You protect yourself by that nur. المصباح في زجاجة. الزجاجة كأنها كوكب دري يؤخذ من شجرة مباركة زيتونة لا شرقية ولا غربية. As if this blitta niyala from a very special minya which is first class A1 Minya Zaitun Yankila all the time. Allah said, He's just giving an example. You just like I say, you are so beautiful like the moon. You are not like a moon, but so beautiful. So Allah here said, as if the dunyala from a minya in first class A1. And Yakadu Zaituha Yudhi'u walau lam tamsasu nar. Minya tu duduk kila. Padahal tak guna api pun. Tapi duduk kila all the time. From where? Nur Allah, Nur Al-Quran. Dua-dua. Nurun ala nur. Nur Al-Quran lagi. Nur Allah lagi. Yahdillahu linurihi man yasha. This nur Allah bagi kepada siapa saja yang dia hendaki. Syiar ikhlas, cari ilmu betul, your iman is haqiqi, you will get that nur. And once you have this nur, muslimin dan muslimat, Rasulullah said what? Ittaqi firasat al-mu'min, fa'innahu yamshi binurillah. Awasilah firasat orang beriman, oleh kerana mereka ni, jalan dengan nur Allah. Once you have this nur, you can even feel things before it happened. You can even, when you talk with people, you can even know, these people genuine ka, these people are crook ka, you can know. Why? Because Allah give you the nur. You can know what is right, what is wrong. You can know where to say no, where to know what is what, because you have the nur. ويضرب الله الأمثال للناس والله بكل شيء عليم. I am giving you, wahai manusia, just like an example. Do you want this nur or not? I can give it to you if you really search for it. by practicing ilmu Allah Al-Quran. You practice ilmu Allah Al-Quran, the nur will be in your heart like a blitter, the lamp bottle, yala all the time. So you will have a nur Allah, nur ilmu, nur Quran, your heart full of nur. So you can know what is what. And then Allah said, how can you know the man get the nur? What is the tanda that the man get the nur? He loved to go to mosque. Before that, he always loved to go to golf. Now he is more to the mosque. That is why, sisters, if you see your husband start to be fond of the mosque, you should be very happy. He got the nur. Tanda nur masu dalam hati suami. Where? Fi biyutin adhinallahu an turfa'a wa yudhkara fiha ismuk. Just like you all ladies. How can I know that all of you get the nur? You have been following me, my classes. You like to go attend class ilmu. You like to come here every week. If we stop, all of you say, when? That means what? Tani'a, you get the nur. For us ladies, majalisul ilmi. For the man, masjid. And also majalisul ilmi. Tanda orang lelaki get the nur. في بيوت أذن الله أن ترفع ويذكر في اسمه. Like so much to go to the mosque. And what they do there? يسبح له فيها بالغدو والآصال. They like to go there. تسبيح سيان ملام. Subuh, cepat-cepat bangun pergi masjid. Maghrib, cepat-cepat pergi masjid. Masya Allah. Tanda cukup baik. Your husband already got the nur. Some man, kalau golf, 5:30 pergi dah. Kalau masjid, tak pergi. They have nur the golf. Not nur the mosque, no. Nur golf. Tanda the man get the nur. They really like to go to the mosque. في بيوت أذن الله أن ترفع ويذكر فيها اسمه. Tanda orang got the nur, they like to go to rumah Allah. Yang tinggi, yang sentiasa nama Allah. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Shadu an la ilaha illallah. They like to go to these houses. They like to have some time there. Rijalun la tulhihim tijaratun wa la bay'un an dhikrillah. The man who don't care about minyaga, who don't care about meeting, who don't care about business, when the azan happened, they run to the mosque. They got the nur already. MashaAllah. Dengar saja azan, they leave everything. The nearest mosque, I go. Ma'mur kan baitullah. Itu tanda nur. That's why, sisters, doa banyak-banyak for your husband. Fall in love with the mosque. Like to go to the mosque. This is the only place they get the nur. The only place he got the nur, not only Friday. So Quran, every day subuh in the mosque. How nice. They really get the nur. Allah give the nur to these people. Mereka ni, la tulhihim tijaratun, wala bay'un an zikrillah. They don't care about minyaga, they don't care about anything. When they hear zikrullah, when they hear the azan. وَإِقَامِ الصَّلَاةِ وَإِيْتَاءِ الزَّكَاةِ. they really very fussy about Salah, they are very fussy about Zakat, then they got the Noor. Some men up till today, sisters, they don't even care about Zakat. They don't never go to mosque except sembahyang raya. Even Friday pun, kadang-kadang pergi, kadang-kadang tidak. No all lah, some men. Sini tak ada lah, sini semua orang baik kan. These people, Allah said, why we are like that? Why this man like that? يَخَافُونَ يَوْمًا تَتَقَلَّبُ فِيهِ الْقُلُوبُ وَالْأَبْصَارُ. Mereka takut kepada hari kiamat. Yang mata akan duduk pergi mari, hati akan gentar. And they know very well going to the mosque. That's why Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in one hadith, sister, he said what? Alangkah kalau Tuhan give me the power to burn rumah-rumah orang yang dengar azan, tapi he never come to the mosque. If Allah give me the power, I will do it. I will burn the house. Hadith sahih. Read it in the blue book. All of you bought the blue book. Bawabab as-salat. Rasulullah said, if only Allah give me the permission, I will burn the houses of the man who hear the azan and he still never come to the mosque. Ma'mur kan baytullah. Orang yang ma'mur baytullah ni, orang yang sudah dapat the Noor. Sekurang-kurangnya subuh ke, you know, isya ke, maghrib ke, at least once a day pun jadi, tapi ma'mur lah baytullah. Allah said what? ليجزيهم الله أحسن ما عملوا ويزيدهم من فضله. Allah will give them rizki, tambah hisab. Allah will bala. Cuba any man among us here, problem in his business. Cuba go to the mosque for 1 week. All the bintu rizki buka. Subhanallah. Cuba any man attending our class here, you have a financial problem and you start to be regular with the mosque. All the bintu rizki will open, subhanallah. Tiba-tiba, everything come. Allah janji. لِيَجْزِيَهُمُ اللَّهُ أَحْسَنَ مَا عَمِلُوا. Ayat 38. وَأَزِيدَهُمْ مِنْ فَضْلِهِ. Allah tambah banyak kurniaan. Apa lagi? وَاللَّهُ يَرْزُقُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. Tuhan bagi rizki kepada siapa yang dia hendaki tanpa hisab. Very, very, very true. I know a doctor in Kelantan. His name is Dr. Haider Ali, Clinic Haider Ali. The only doctor yang go to the mosque 5 times a day. And he is ordinary doctor. He is no specialist, nothing. All the specialists around him, orthopedic surgeon lah, Abu Nama, kidney professor lah, open clinics. But he still his clinic, the most popular clinic, and he is the richest. You ask Haider Ali Bunya Clinic in Clanton. Very famous. Patient waiting because of what? Dr. Bagi Masjid. Zuhur, Dr. Masjid, tunggu dulu. Asar, Dr. Masjid, tunggu dulu. Isha, Dr. Masjid, tunggu dulu. And he is the richest in Clanton. Subhanallah. Because Allah said, after all, I am the one who give the rizki. Rizki come from me. Ma'amur lah baytullah. Go lah to baytullah. Because this is the only tanda that the man get the Noor. And the only place the man get the Noor. That's why, sisters, we must encourage our husband. Our husband maybe is too late because they are the bimbibin and they might not like it. At least don't let what is happening to your husband happen to your children. Encourage your children while they are young to go to the mosque. I always remind them, go to the mosque. is the only place you get the nur. For us, ladies, we get the nur of ilmu, classes. We go. That's why the hari kiamat nanti, group of people going to heaven. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam hayran. And these people themselves hayran. We have a lot of sin. We are not that good. Why Allah bangi kita masuk dulu? Then Allah, they will hear suara Allah. Allah saying what? Kuntum tu'ammiruna biyutillahi bimasal bimajalisil ilmi fahaqqat jannati. Kamu semua ma'mur baitullah dengan majalisul ilmi, dengan hadir majlis ilmu. Dan oleh kerana itu, haqqat jannati, syurga aku wajib kepada kamu. Itu, we are doing it, alhamdulillah. We always have majalisul ilmi. Tambah pula, if the man go to the mosque for prayer, mashallah. Okay? And of course, muslimin dan muslimat yang saya hormat sekalian, ayat 35 ni is very good for amalan. If every morning you read this ayat after subuh, you read it once and you dua, Allahumma ja'al amami nura khalfi, depan saya nur, belakang saya nur, kanan saya nur, kiri saya nur, atas saya nur, bawah saya nur, saya sendiri jadi nur. Doa like that. And keep on saying, nurun ala nur, sabu muka. Nurun ala nur, sabu tiga kali. Your face will be berseri-seri, your heart will be bersih. Very good for amalan. That's why orang tua semua hafal ayat 35 surah An-Nur. The ayat is very famous. And Rasulullah always read while he's going to the mosque in the morning. And he will say what? Ya Allah, ya Tuhanku, biya depan saya jadi ada nur, belakang saya ada nur, kanan saya nur, kiri saya nur, atas saya nur, bawah saya nur, saya sendiri jadi nur. And tarik nafas to as a dua. We call this one doa nak pergi masjid. It's very well known. Ha? Nak tahajud pun boleh. Waktu tahajud atau waktu nak pergi masjid. Yes, the belakang, atas, bawah, kanan, kiri. Very good. Okay? And muslimat yang saya hormat sekalian, muslimin dan muslimat, if you have a problem and you don't know what to decide, what to choose, nak beli tak nak beli, atau nak jual tak nak jual, nak terima tunan tu atau tak nak terima, nak kawan mak salih atau tak nak, you can ask Allah with this ayat. You read the ayat and you keep touching your heart. Nurun ala nur, nurun ala nur, nurun ala nur. Give me the nur, ya Allah. What decision I should make? You ask Allah to give you the nur. What decision you should make? Also good. Either you do istikhara or you do this amalan, can be also very good. You can do even both. Okay? And we know already, fadilah pergi masjid ni, tanda orang sudah dapat nur Allah, and Allah will give them rizki, tambah, hisab. Okay? Baik. Of course, all this will happen to siapa? Orang yang get the nur of Allah by nur Al-Quran, nur ilmu. Kalau orang yang tak praktis Al-Quran, kufur dengan Al-Quran, Allah said what? وَالَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا أَعْمَالُهُمْ كَسَرَابٍ بِقِيعَةٍ يَحْسَبُهُ الظَّمْآنُ مَاءً. Orang kafir ni seperti orang yang just imagine. They do a lot of work in this dunya, but they don't believe in Allah. They don't believe in the Quran. And they believe what? They believe that they are okay. They are okay. In the end, the akhirat nanti, they will find out that Just like orang dahaga, nampak ada air, bila pergi nak cari air tu, they found out that Allah will do the balasan di hari kiamat nanti. Allah said, وَالَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا أَعْمَالُهُمْ كَسَرَابٍ بِقِيعَةٍ يَحْسَبُ الظَّمْآنُ مَاءً. Seperti, they imagine saja, as if there is water, and they are very thirsty for that water, then they found it is was what? Imagination, mirage. Very good. وَوَجَدَ حَتَّى إِذَا جَاءَهُ لَمْ يَجِدُهُ شَيْئًا. Di akhirat nanti, buku kosong. All the dunia duduk fikir, I am okay. Kufur dengan apa yang Allah bawa. Di akhirat tengok, kosong. Nothing. Allah ada to do the hisab. Maknanya, he was cheated with what? With dunia. Seperti orang, very thirsty, nampak ada air, tengok, it's just mirage. There is nothing. Allah waiting for him to do hisab. فَوَفَّاهُ حِسَابَهُ وَاللَّهُ سَرِيعُ الْحِسَابُ. Allah akan buat hisab, cuba mungkin. You do, enjoy yourself dunia, kufur with all this, follow hawa nafsu, follow the shaitan, do whatever you want to do. You never follow merinta Allah, you will be in the akhirah. Fikir okay, is not okay. Seperti orang dahaga, fikir ada air, but there is nothing. Kosong. Allah just giving an example. And he give another example. Ataupun kazulumatin fi bahrin lujiyin yaghshahu mawjun min fawqihi mawjun min fawqihi sahab. Atau seperti orang duduk tepi laut dalam gelap, ombak kuat, laut sudah gelap, ombak-ombak pun sudah gelap, gelap atas gelap. Kalau tangan sendiri pun tak nampak. Kalau nak tengok tangan, maknanya apa? Orang yang tak ada ilmu ni, rumah mereka gelap, life mereka gelap. They know nothing. They are behaving without ilmu. Salah atas salah atas salah. Sampai apa? Khatam Allah. Summun, bukmun, umyun. So Allah give another example. Seperti orang duduk tepi laut dalam gelap. Ombak habis kuat. Gelap atas gelap atas gelap. Sampai your own hand cannot see. Maknanya apa? Jahil, tak tahu apa. Doing the wrong things, but you don't feel it. So, what is the end? Habis menasab. Habis laknat. Zulumatun ba'duha fawqa ba'd. Gelap atas gelap atas gelap. Iza akhraja yadahu lam yakad yaraha. Your own hand pun tak nampak. Kerana duduk dalam gelap. It's just a contoh. Amithalan, you know, you are so much jahil that you become dalam kegelapan sampai doing anything tak berasa salah. Kerana apa? Lack of the nur, lack of the ilmu. So Allah said, وَمَنْ لَمْ يَجْعَلِ اللَّهُ لَهُ نُورًا فَمَا لَهُ مِنْ نُورٍ. Barang siapa Tuhan tak bagi nur, tidak akan dapat any nur. All the nur come from Allah. Be good with Allah, Allah give you the nur. Search for ilmu Allah, Allah give you the nur. You try to be jahil, you will be always dalam kegelapan. That is why Muslimin dan Muslimat yang saya hormat sekalian, Rasulullah said what? العلم نور. الموت is نور والجهل موت قبل الموت كي جاهلان تو ماتي سبلو ماتي most of the people yang terlibat in dalam maksiat duduk buat all the nonsense is because of what? Jahilu. They know nothing about nothing. Jahil. You see orang di negeri barat, like we used to see Dallas lah, we used to see all this, he sleep with his own sister-in-law, he sleep with, terrible, jahilu. Zulumatun ba'adwa fa'uqaba. People yang kita dengar, father sleep with his own daughter, grandfather sleep with a cucu. Is what, why it happened? Zulumatun ba'adwa fa'uqaba. Gelap atas gelap atas gelap. Jahil lagi, no ilmu lagi. So the whole house is gelap, full of maksiat. Wal'iyazu billah, mentak jauh. Allah said, وَمَنْ لَمْ يَجْعَلِ اللَّهُ لَهُ نُورًا فَمَا لَهُ مِنْ نُورًا. Barang siapa Allah tak bagi nur, he will never get the nur. So you want the nur? Mentak dengan Allah. Allahumma ij'al amami nura wa min khalfi nura. Muslimin dan muslimat yang saya hormati sekalian, you don't have to dua in Arabic. Dua it in Malay pun tak apa. Every morning, make it as a must before subuh. Ya Allah, ya Tuhanku, ya depan saya nur, belakang saya nur, kanan saya nur, kiri saya nur, bawah saya nur, atas saya nur, saya sendiri jadi nur. Nurun ala nur. Sambu kepala sambu. And this is amalan Nabi every morning while he is going to the mosque. And of course last time kita belajar for ladies how to make your face always bersiri-siri. Ya Badi', ya Nur, ya Hadi, ya Allah, ya Allah, ya Allah, you remember? Tiup, sabu muka, and read ayat Nur, ayat 35. You don't have to go to facial, but your face always ada Nur, always bersiri-siri. With the Quran, always, every morning, you read ayat 35, and you call Allah with these three names. Ya Allah, ya Badi', ya Nur, ya Hadi, ya Allah, ya Allah, ya Allah. Sabu muka, sabu tubuh, and doa lah. There are a few names of nama Allah yang khas untuk muka kita bersiri-siri. Ya Allah, ya Allah, ya Badi', Badi' means make things so beautiful. Badi', ya Nur, Nur, Badi', Badi' nama khasna Allah al-Badi'. Badal ya Ain, Badi', ya Allah, ya Badi', ya Nur, okay, Nur, ya Hadi, bagi bertunjuk, cause the Nur is bertunjuk, okay, ya Allah, ya Allah, ya Allah, tiga kali, ya Allah, ya Badi', ya Nur, ya Hadi. Ya Allah, ya Allah, ya Allah. And then you read, ya Allah, ya Tuhanku, depan saya nur, belakang saya nur, kanan nur, kiri nur, atas nur, bawah nur, nurun ala nur. Sabu muka tiga kali. Wrinkles will not, you will not have wrinkles. You try, if you do always, always. Tak bayar botak, tak bayar all the nonsense. All this tak bayar. Umur 70 pun, very, tak nampak sedikit pun tua. Very good. Orang tua semua tahu amalan ni. Ya Allah, ya Badi', ya Nur, ya Hadi, ya Allah, ya Allah, ya Allah. Allahumma ja'al fi qalbi nura wa ala yamini nura wa ala yasar. Doa in Malay pun tak apa. Dalam hati saya ada nur, depan saya nur, belakang bawah nur, atas nur. Saya sendiri jadi nur. Nurun ala nur. umur 3 kali. Ulama said, try to hafal ayatul nur. Very good. If you read ayatul nur ni every morning, very good. Yeah. Ayat 35. So, whenever you are in trouble and you want very fast, Allah help you, keep on zikr nurun ala nur, nurun ala nur, nurun ala nur. Ayat number
35
ada di bawah sekali. Ha? Nampak? Just gusuk kepala and say, nurun ala nur, nurun ala nur, nur atas nur, nur atas nur. Allah will give you the guidance. This is for emergency. You don't know what to decide. Traffic jam, you don't know where to go, right or left. Keep on zikr, no, very good. Because Allah will give you the ilham, what to do fast. It's very good for amalan juga, ayat yang berbunyi, nurun ala nur, which is ada dalam ayat 35 hujur. Yahdillahu linurihi man yasha. Nurun ala nur. يهدي الله لنوره من يشاء أن يصر. Okay, very good for شباب شباب دبق هداية وتدو. نور على نور يهدي الله لنوره من يشاء. يا الله يا تهدك طلولا give me the نور وتدو. Undecided traffic jam, you don't know what to do. Very good. Okay. Muslimat dan muslimin yang saya hormat sekalian, habis dalam and Allah would, that's why, because of this ayat, the surah nama An-Nur, because of ayat An-Nur, ayat number 35, yang Allah want to tell us, the only way to get the nur is the ilmu, and the best ilmu to give the nur is the Quran. Once you have nur al-Quran and you have nur Allah, this thing will be in your heart, macam pelita yang duduk ni all the time. So you must always be sure that you have the ilmu al-Quran, because this is the only thing will be your pelita and help you when you are in trouble. Nurun ala nur. Tan the nur of the man they love the most. Okay? Bye. If people without this nur, they will be macam orang dalam gelap. Laut pun gelap, ombak pun gelap, gelap atas gelap. Sampai tangan sendiri pun tak nampak. Waliyazubillah, mentak jauh. Now, muslimat dan muslimin yang saya hormat sekalian, Allah giving tanda-tanda kuasanya seperti ini surah Makkiyah, to make you believe in Allah, to make your aqidah strong. Allah like to give tanda tanda kuasa. So Allah asking, alam tara anna Allah yusabbihu lahu man fis samawati wal ard. Do you know, ya Muhammad, that not only manusia yang tasbih, all the makhluk tasbih. Landi tasbih, bumi tasbih, gunung ganang tasbih, burung tasbih, batu tasbih, benda ada akal tasbih, benda tak ada akal tasbih, every makhluk tasbih. So at least this is a knowledge for us, but we don't know. Even meja macam ni tasbih, even pintu tasbih. Sometimes, for example, the water, you hear the water, tong tong tong, it could be tasbih. The bintu, you open the bintu, see, maybe tasbih. You see the chicha, maybe that's tasbih. So today, we know from Surah An-Nur, every makhluk, whether ada nyawa, tak ada nyawa, ada akal, tak ada akal, tasbih. Alam tara, anna Allah yusabbihu lahu man fis samawati wal ard. والطير صافات, even burun, the bird, they saf, they be saf, they salah juga, That's why sometimes waktu maghrib, you see the bird, one depend, dua belakang, tiga lagi belakang, lima lagi belakang. Maybe they are praying berjamaah. Subhanallah. Allah said, وَالطَّيْرُ صَافَّاتٍ. Even burun bun, saf dimi saf, wa'aba. كُلٌ قَدْ عَلِمَ صَلَاتَهُ وَتَسْبِيحَهُ. Every makhluk know how to pray, how to tasbih. They have their own way of praying. Subhanallah. This is knowledge for us. Even sumut, salat. Even limbu, salat. Even kambit, salat. They have their own way of salat. They have their own way of saf. They have their own way of tasbih, which we don't know. Subhanallah. Kullun قَدْ عَلِمَ صَلَاتَهُ وَتَسْبِيحَهُ وَاللَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِمَا يَفْعَلُونَ. Only Allah knows what they are doing. We don't know. Subhanallah. وَلِلَّهِ مُلْكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Semua milik Allah, including you yourself. You, your harta, everything is milik Allah. We are milik Allah. If Allah want to take, sekejap saja. We are tubuh dan nyawa. Tubuh is from the body, will go to body. Dan nyawa will go to Allah. So Allah said, وَلِلَّهِ مُلْكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَإِلَى اللَّهِ الْمَصِيرِ. All of you coming back to me. You have to be kind to me. You have to be good to me. Because all of you coming back to me. إلى الله المصير. Another thing, ألم ترى, whenever Muslimin dan Muslimat yang saya hormat sekalian, tengok perkataan ألم ترى, you have to berhati-hati. Did you see? Did you realize? ألم ترى, did you melihat? Another one, apa dia? أن الله يجزي سحابا. Allah create the awan, the sahab, awan, betul. And then, tiba-tiba, the awan may become too condensed, too heavy. ثُمَّ يُؤَلِّفُ بَيْنَهُ. Too heavy, sampai jadi berat, jadi apa? Hujan. See, you don't go even to school, misalnya. You can know science also from the Quran. That's why I said what? Nur. Quran to Nur. Bibul Ummiyu, tak boleh tulis, tak boleh baca. Can be alim if they understand the Quran. Subhanallah. ثُمَّ يُؤَلِّفُ بَيْنَهُ ثُمَّ يَجْعَلْهُ رُكَامًا. Become too heavy, become too thick. فَتَرَى الْوَدْقَ يَخْرُجُ مِنْ خِلَالِكَ. Tiba-tiba hujan turun. Subhanallah. Wa yunazzilu minas samai min jibalin fiha min baradin. Some negeri from the langit, the snow come down, become in a form of gunung ganan of snow. We have seen that. The whole hill is made of snow. Some country which is a snow country, subhanallah. Fiha min baradin, so cool. Not all the country. Fayusibu bihi man yasha' wa yasrifu an man yasha'. Some people get the snow, some people don't get the snow. Yakadu sana barqihi yadhhabu bil absar. Some country, they have the report. The bitter that you cannot sit down. Some countries don't have. In Egypt, we never have this rainbow bitter. If it happened, everyone will say qiyamah. Something ajaib for us. Only Malaysia have. I don't know about other countries that they have. But I have never seen the kilat except in Malaysia. No other. In my country, Egypt, we never have this. If we have that, I think that means Qiyamah Allah. So Allah said, some people, when they see that kilab, يَكَادُ الْبَرْقُ يَخْسِفْ يُزْهِبُ بِالْحَمْبِرْ مَطْنَ أَهِلًا تَكُدْ because it's too strong. يُقَلِّبُ اللَّهُ اللَّيْلَ وَالنَّهَارَ Allah buat siang, buat malam. Kadang-kadang siang panjang, malam pendek. Kadang-kadang malam pendek, siang panjang. Kadang-kadang in London, buka puasa 9 o'clock at night. Kadang-kadang buka puasa 4 o'clock in the afternoon. Malam sangat panjang, siang pendek, siang sangat panjang, malam pendek. Siapa yang buat ini semua? Allah. Inna fi dhalika la'ibratan lu'ulil absar. Inilah satu ihtibar kepada orang yang guna akal. Use your akal to love Allah. You will never love Allah unless you know siapa Allah. All the makhluk tasbih. Tasbih in the way which we don't know. Even burun tasbih. Even benda ada akal tasbih. Benda tak ada akal pun tasbih. And in the end of the day, all of us will go back to Allah. Allah said. And some more, you must know, wahai Muhammad, that I am the one who bring out the water from the sky. When the awan becomes so strong, tiba-tiba, too heavy, hujan will come down. Some countries, hujan don't come down, but snow. Some countries, they don't have the snow, but they have the ripple, the bitil. Subhanallah. Some people, the malam become too long. Some country, siang long, malam short. It's all done by who? By Allah. Wallahu khalaqa kulla dabbatin. New knowledge to us also. Any makhluk come from water, including us. We are created also from water. Ayat binne is ayat. So any makhluk come from water. Subhanallah. Wallahu khalaqa kulla dabbatin min ma'. Asal usul ini makhluk water. Subhanallah. Okay. Makhluk Allah ni pula belik sikit. Faminhum man yamshi ala batni. Ada makhluk Allah yang jalan atas buruk dia. Tak ada kaki. Ular lah. Ular tak ada kaki. Dia jalan cuk. Tak ada kaki langsung. Subhanallah. وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَمْشِي عَلَى رِجْلَيْنِ Ada makhluk yang dua kaki saja. Macam kita manusia. So Allah said, ada makhluk dua kaki. Kita, ayam dua kaki. Itik dua atau empat? Dua. Tak ingat, dah lama tak tengok. So Allah said, ada makhluk yang dua kaki saja. Ada makhluk yang empat kaki. Ada makhluk yang 44 kaki. Lima. Subhanallah. Minhum man yamshi ala batnih. Ada yang jalan atas perut dia. Wa minhum man yamshi ala rijlain. Ada yang jalan dua kaki. Wa minhum man yamshi ala arba'. Ada yang empat kaki. Kambin empat kaki. Kambin betul empat kaki. Empat kaki. Yakhluqullahu ma yasha'. Allah cipta apa saja yang dia hendaki. Inna Allaha ala kulli syai'in qadir. Allah maha berkuasa atas segalanya. We call this ayat makiyah to make what our aqidah strong. Love Allah, kena Allah. Dan ini tujuan Al-Quran lah, ma'rifatullah. Serupa juga dalam Yasin, ayatul lahum al-lailu naslakhu minhu an-nar, ayatul lahum anna hamalna zurriyatahum fil fulki lahum mash'hud, ayatul lahum al-ard al-maytah ahyaynaha wa akhrajna minha habban faminhu ya'kulun. All this is what tandak wasa Allah li'alam semesta yang bila kita faham. Subhanallah. Inna Allah ala kulli shay'in قدير. أوكي، لقد أنزلنا آيات مبينات. إني سموا آيات نيطة، والله يهدي من يشاء إلى صراط مستقيم. Sesungguhnya Allah bagi hidayah kepada siapa saja. As-sirat al-mustaqim. If you know, if you think, if you tadabbur, you will love Allah, you will ta'at Allah, you will get what? As-sirat al-mustaqim. Now, mulai ayat 47 sampai ayat 57. 10 ayat muslimin dan muslimat yang saya hormati sekalian, apa munafik. Because you must know the surah, sebab nuzulnya orang munafik buat tuduhan buruk terhadap Sayyidah Aisyah. So Allah butir in the surah 10 ayat sifat-sifat orang munafik. Now, because you will ask, why tiba-tiba we are talking about the nur, we are talking about the hidayah, we are talking about the zina, we are talking about benda-benda yang mencegah zina, tiba-tiba sibuk hal munafik pula. Because to let us know ciri-ciri orang munafik, and to let Nabi Muhammad know ciri-ciri orang munafik, and because of this, they have done lah the fitnah terhadap Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So Allah said, وَيَقُولُونَ آمَنَّا بِاللَّهِ وَبِالرَّسُولِ وَأَطَعْنَا. Mereka ni kata iman, ta'at. ثُمَّ يَتَوَلَّى فَرِيقٌ مِّنْهُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِ ذَلِكَ وَمَا أُولَٰئِكَ بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Kata mulut saja. Sebenarnya, they are not mu'min. Be careful. وَإِذَا دُعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ لِيَحْكُمَ بَيْنَهُمْ إِذَا فَرِيقٌ مِّنْهُمْ مُعْرِضُونَ. Banggil untuk buat discuss, why you say this, why you buat the fitnah. Tak mau mari, munafik. Tak mau semuka. Tak mau. Malu nak datang. Allah said, وَإِذَا دُعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ لِيَحْكُمَ بَيْنَهُمْ إِذَا فَرِيقٌ مِّنْهُمْ مُعْرِضُونَ. Nak buat hukum, panggil. Nak berdebat, they don't want to come. And this also for you, very good to know your friend, whether they are munafiq or not. If they are munafiq, they will never come if they are wrong. They are wrong, they don't want to smoke. مَمَرِي وَإِنْ يَكُنْ لَهُمُ الْحَقُّ يَأْتُوا إِلَيْهِ مُذْعِنِينَ. Kalau dia really ada hak, ada something dia boleh dapat, they come cuba-cuba. Kalau tak boleh dapat apa, they know they are in the loss, they will never come. أَفِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ أَمْ ارْتَابُوا أَمْ يَخَافُونَ أَنْ يَحِيفَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ ورسوله. Hati busuk, paranoid, dia takut daripada Allah dan Rasulnya. Bal ulaika humuz zalimun. Ini orang yang betul-betul aniaya kadiri. Sebetulnya kalau mereka iman, kalau mereka betul, bila Allah suruh Rasulullah panggil, they should come. They should say, سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا. They should not say, سَمِعْنَا وَأَصَيْنَا. Sikap munafik, سَمِعْنَا وَأَصَيْنَا. So Allah said, إِنَّمَا كَانَ قَوْلُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ إِذَا دُعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ لِيَحْكُمَ بَيْنَهُمْ. Kalau orang beriman sungguh, Nabi panggil, nak buat hukum, they must come. أن يقولوا سمعنا وأطعنا أولئك هم المفلحون. إني أوراني أمباي. All these Muslimin and Muslimat yang saya hormati sekalian, come in between to make Nabi Muhammad tenang, to tell him, these are sikap munafiq. They are like that. They like to do the fitnah. Bila nak berdebat, bila nak semuka, tak nak mari. Kalau dia iman sungguh, they should ta'at, they should come. But because they are malu, they don't want to come. Munafiq. Anyhow, وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ وَيَخْشَ اللَّهَ وَيَتَّقِهِ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْفَائِزُونَ. Highlight this ayat untuk amalan. How to be untun dunia akhirat. وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ وَيَخْشَ اللَّهَ وَيَتَّقِهِ. You do empat perkara ni, you lulus in this dunia. Apa dia? Taat ke Tuhan, taat ke Nabi, takut ke Tuhan, bertakwa ke Tuhan. Fear Allah. Fear Allah. Do what Allah ask you to do. Taat ke Tuhan, taat ke Nabi. Ini orang yang untun. Ulaika humul faizun. Ini orang yang sangat-sangat untuk. Allah said what? Wa aqsamu billahi jahda'im. I give you an example, ya Muhammad, to show they are munafiq. Dia sumpah dah, kalau perang datang, akan keluar untuk berperang. Bila perang datang, they are never out. Munafiq. Maknanya apa? Cakap tak bikin. Kalau ada war, nak tolong, nak berjuang. Bila hukum berjuangan datang, tak nak pergi. Munafik. Allah give, wa aqsamu billahi jahda aimanihi la in amartahum la yakhrujunna. They already sumba. If you ask them come to the war, we will come. Sumba. Tetapi qul la tuqsimu. Tak payah sumbah lah. Tak payah kata wallahi saya akan pergi. Kerana apa? Ta'atun ma'rufatun. I know very well. Sumpah bohong. Maknanya, one of the tanda munafiq also, for us to know, sisters, Quran teach you know how to know people. They like to sumpah bohong. When your daughter kawin, I will help you. I will get you all what you want. I will do your antaram for you. I will do this. When your daughter nak kawin, ghaib. Tak tahu pergi ke mana dah. Munafiq. Typical munafiq. Janji tak bikin. I'm sure we meet a lot of this type of people banyak. So Allah said, La tuqsimu ta'atun ma'rufatun inna allaha khabirun bima ta'malun. Wahai Muhammad, tell them lah, Qul ati'u allaha wa ati'u rasul. Sikap kita ni, orang yang beriman should be what? Ta'at ke Tuhan, ta'at ke Nabi. Orang munafik ni, tak ta'at ke Rasulullah. Anti Rasulullah. Even sanggup nak buat fitnah terhadap Rasulullah. Fa'in tawallaw, fa'innama alaihi ma'humila wa'alaikum ma'humiltum. Mereka tak mau juga, up to them lah. You have done your part. You have advised them. وَإِن تُطِيعُوهُ تَهْتَدُوا. Wahai manusia, wahai orang munafik, baik ta'atlah ke Nabi. Orang yang ta'at ke Nabi ni dapat hidayah. That's why Muslimin dan Muslimat, Rasulullah SAW before mati di Haji Al-Wada', he said what? I leave two things for you. If you jaga baik-baik, you will never sesak dunia, sesak akhirat. Al-Quran dan As-Sunnah. We should love the Sunnah as much as we love the Quran. Anything Nabi said you must do, you must do. Smile when you see people, smile. Not chop salam when you see people, not chop salam. Love each other, love each other. Jangan maki hamun orang, jangan maki hamun orang. Jangan sombong, jangan sombong. All this nasihat Nabi. Anything Nabi ajar, we should really do. Because Allah said what? وَإِن تُطِيعُوهُ tahtadu. If you follow Rasulullah, you get the hidayah. وَمَا عَلَى الرَّسُولِ إِلَّا الْبَلَاغِ الْمُبِينِ. Kerja Rasul, balag, da'wah. You follow him, you get the hidayah. You don't follow him, you lose a lot.